This is my surface grinder. It's a great machine tool with one drawback. It is very manual to operate and the handle cranking is very repetitive. I want to add an option for automation without the complexities of making it fully CNC. Step 1. Add a DC motor to your X-axis and stir thoroughly. I will make this motor belt drive the X-axis. But first, I need to make an adapter. And I'll start by chopping some mild steel round bar in the bandsaw. I then went to the lathe to face and turn the outside. Then drilling and reaming of the bore, and this is for a control plunger that I'll make later. I turned the part around and placed it in a collet, and this allows me to turn the other end and bore it to fit onto the machine. Taking it over to the mill, I need two slots. The first is a through slot into the reamed bore, and I started by milling up the center and then stepping sideways each way to finish it to the correct width. The second slot is halfway through the thickness, and this is for a keyway, and this will retain the handwheel. And to finalize, I need a tapped hole which will be used to retain this adapter onto the existing handwheel shaft on the machine. And the part is done. I'm now going to make the control plunger that fits in the adapter. This part is turned for a sliding fit in the adapter bore that we previously made. After parting and flipping around, the end is then prepared for threading. I marked the surface with Sharpie and performed a scratch pass. And then I can confirm my thread pitch settings before going to town on it. I now require a small thread to retain a little pin that's going to lock the entire assembly together. I need it to be well seated, so I make a counter bore, and then I'm going to drill and power tap to finish this part. And now for that pin. So I turned it to form a shoulder, and that's going to seat in the counter bore that we previously made. I then used my tailstock die holder to thread the end, and after parting off, this piece was done. The final part for the adapter is the timing belt pulley. These are purchased off the shelf with a pilot hole, which I opened up and bored to fit my adapter shaft. I then formed an enlarged bore hole in one side, and this will make sense shortly. Over in the mill, I set up a custom slotting tool to cut a keyway. I aligned it square using the vise. I chose to manually slot rather than use my slotting head because this part is aluminium and it's quite easy to work and it's probably faster than setting up the whole head. Now to assemble the main adapter, the plunger control, the locking pin, and then the pulley. You can see that the plunger slides the pin back and forth within the keyway. In one position, the pulley free spins with the pin in the enlarged bore, while in the other position, the pulley is locked to the shaft. I then installed the handwheel backwards. This is to provide the correct spacing, but allow tool clearance so I can determine exactly where I need to put my circlip retaining groove. And this will keep everything locked together. Installing on the grinder is quick and easy, although I still need a mounting plate for the motor bracket. This was quickly made up on the drill press. I've tidied up the cable management and tried to make it nice and neat. And here you can see the adapter. It's very easy to switch between an automated and a manual operation. I'm very happy with how it turned out. The machine X-axis has these travel stops, but I want electronic stops with limit switches. There are two ways of implementing these, as a bump stop, which can be crashed into, or an overrunning stop that does not impede movement. I'm going to use the latter type. I modified the existing stop block with an adapter plate. This will mount the limit switch. I drilled a hole through my grinder table, and this is for the limit switch signal wiring. I then made up these simple stops and they are installed in the table T slot. I found having these finger tight is perfectly fine. And here you can see how the overrunning style works rather nicely. This next bit made me nervous. I needed to mill this casting to install a Z-axis motor. I was very careful here knowing there was a spring of unknown strength, but it went okay. I want a flat spot on the underside. I wrapped up the bearings to keep all the cast iron dust out. And then at the mill, I milled a flat in the underside and then drilled and tapped. I could then remount the casting and measure for the required bracket. I've been trying to mill things in a single setup where I can, and this ensures things are square, accurate, and much faster. I added a bevel for weld prep, but in hindsight it wasn't needed, as this is only a fillet weld, but it gave me an excuse to use my bevel cutter, which I do enjoy using. And off camera, I made up the remainder of the bracket. And this is just simply flat bar to the right thickness. And this accepts a stepper motor bracket and securely holds the stepper motor. And the fit up of all this was very nice. I'm quite happy with how it went. To mount Z-axis limit switches, I'm going to be using off the shelf aluminium T-track. I found the countersunk holes in this weren't deep enough for my screws that I had, so I made them a little bit deeper for a flush finish. I don't want things to snag. I carefully indicated the T-track so it was square to the machine axis. And then I used standard aluminium T-nuts. And once again, we have a nice overrunning limit switch action. Now I need a place to hold all of my electronics. I'll then make a simple frame to support a cabinet. And then some more drilling and tapping. And the frame is rigidly bolted to the machine. Now to work on the actual cabinet. And it has this handy plate to install the electronics. Now I could use this to lay out everything and then drill the required holes. I'm concerned about the electronics overheating, so I'm going to install vents. I carefully cut some holes near the top and bottom for a nice convection flow, and these end up looking quite reasonable. I'm running out of space a little bit, so I'm going to mount my power supply to the side of the box. I use painter's tape to pick up the hole pattern and transfer it to the cabinet. And this is a really good trick. This gave me perfect hole spacing. At this stage, I figured I might as well try it out now. After a lot of wiring, it's all starting to take shape. I was trying to keep things neat and using things like terminal blocks, which I epoxied into place. I've made the E-stop kill the control signals to the VSD and all the motors. But there is an issue. The VSD runs on a different voltage. Rather than blow up my Arduino and electronics, I decided to use a relay. So the Arduino voltage can trigger the higher voltage circuit and switch it on and off. I did have issues with the wiring though. It turns out I'm a little bit colorblind and got my wires crossed. Literally. Now it's coding time. By now everyone's probably aware of ChatGPT's coding ability and I thought I'd try it out. The AI understood the concept of a power feed, which was really cool. After a bit of prompting, it generated somewhat reasonable code. However, it did require some manual debugging. I did have to create my own interesting code. I had to compensate for the table inertia and where it overshot the limit switches so that it could bounce between two stops. Once this was all resolved, I finally had a workable power feed with its automated x-axis and the incremental z-axis with a feed amount that I can manually set. I have provision for a y-axis stepper motor, which is easily toggled with a switch, but this is a future upgrade. Now to try it out. I want to grind some more rotary broaches. I'm still using an indexer, but I'll eventually improve this fixture. So I can turn on the spindle, automate the x-axis, and walk away while the z-axis feeds down. Everything comes to a stop when the z-axis limit switch is triggered, and then I can manually reset to grind the next face. And yes, rotary broaches will be for sale again shortly. Stay tuned. Thanks for watching.